In the name of Allah, the most merciful, the most gracious. I am Kamran Muhammad Kamran, MCF 1901587, University of Education, Township Campus, Lahore. I'm English, the semester 4th, the shift evening. So today we are going to discuss the novel Reluctant Fundamentalist. The topic of the novel, the symbols used in the novel. We will try to discuss the symbol used in the novel Reluctant Fundamentalist. So if we take a review, overview of this novel is written by Mohsin Hamid, a Pakistani author. And this novel was published on March 1st, 2007. This novel was written in context of 9/11 incident. And this novel is a kind of dramatic monologue, a conversation between a Pakistani, Chengiz, his name is Chengiz, and a stranger American in Lahore at the table of tea in a famous cafe, which is famous for its taste of tea. There is also the symbolic significance of this novel. Various symbols have been used to convey the ideas and concepts, different invisible and intangible concepts. So in today's session we will try to represent on the topic symbol used in this novel. So moving forward, first of all we will see that what symbolism or symbols in literature are. So actually symbols are the maybe objects to convey ideas. According to Merriam-Webster dictionary, now there are two definitions which I have quoted here. First is, this is very simple definition, that it is a system of symbols or representation. It means that this is a system in which we use symbols or to represent things, to represent ideas. The second definition is more comprehensive. It says that the art or practice of using symbols. What is symbolism? It is art or practice of using symbols, especially by investing things. We invest things with the thing with a symbolic meaning. We use things, objects to represent meaning. Or it is or by expressing the invisible or intangible. Or symbolism, what is it? Expressing the invisible or intangible, a means of visible or sensuous representation. We represent visible things, intangible things by the means of visible and sensuous representation. We use simple things to represent complex ideas. So this is the brief definition and meaning of symbolism in literature. So moving forward towards our session and main topic. So here is the list of contents that we are going to discuss in this session. We have to discuss the symbol used in the novel. So first symbol is symbol of beard. Second is the symbol of Underwood Samson. Third is the fall of Twin Towers. Fourth is the symbol of names. Fifth is the symbol of bats. And sixth is the symbolic significance of tea or cup of tea. So we begin with the symbol of beard, which is the first symbol we are going to discuss in this session. The symbol of beard. First, we will base our discussion on the symbol of beard on these four points. So in this novel, the symbol of beard is the symbol of connection to homeland for Chengiz. Because after the incident of 9/11, after falling of Twin Tower, Because Chinggis was working in the firm Underwood Sampson, he was highly recognized employee of his company. But after the incident of 9/11, the tag was on the Muslim world that this terrorism is from the Muslim world, and Americans were considering every Muslim as a terrorist who is keeping them there. So he was treated in bad way after 9/11. He was treated as a stranger. The people who were his friends, the company who was bought of him, no, was a different company, different firm. He was treated as a stranger. So as a connection to his homeland, he lets his beard to grow. At first, initially, he was trying to be American. He was adopting the foreign culture to become American. But after this incident, he realized that after so much hard work, after so much struggle, he was not an American. Because the incident of 9/11 exposes the hypocrisy of America. And so now he started to feel to regain his identity. So as a connection to his homeland, he lets his beard to grow. Second is post 9/11 symbol of radical Islam. So after 9/11, the beard became a symbol of radical Islam. Every person who was keeping beard, in the eyes of America, he was a terrorist. So this has become a symbol of radical Islam for Americans after 9/11, because everyone who was bearded was considered to be a terrorist or a facilitator of terrorism. So that's why after 9/11, when the Chinggis has grown his beard, he was treated differently by America and he left America. The third thing is the reclamation of cultural identity. This is also a symbol of reclamation of cultural identity. Initially, Chinggis was so much occupied with the dream of America. He was trying to become a corporate American young man. He was not proud of his country, but after suffering from treatment of American after 9/11, he decided to reclaim his cultural identity. So to reclaim his cultural identity, he grew his beard to make connection his home to his homeland, his cultural background. So here's beard also symbolizes the cultural identity for Chinggis. And the fourth and last point where I will discuss about the symbol of beard is the misconception. It symbolizes the misconception about Islam by American and Western world, that Islam is a violent and extremist religion. So every person who is bearing beard, who is having beard, is a extremist and violent person. So this was a misconception about beard. This was due to ignorance of American and Western world from the Islam, because they don't know that the teaching of Islam, the tradition of Islam, says to the Muslim world that they should grow their beard. So moving forward, our second symbol, which is Underwood Sampson. So Underwood Sampson was a firm where Chinggis work. So about Underwood Sampson as a symbol, we'll discuss on these 4 points. First, that Underwood Sampson symbolizes American dream. What was American dream? American dream was this, that anyone who will work hard will get reward in America, in Underwood Sampson. Without any discrimination, without any gender discrimination, racism or prejudice. So it symbolizes American dream. It also symbolizes the US United States with all its power and optimism. But this was the first impression of Underwood Simpson. It was not so. Later on, his limitation about the Dream of America was exposed. The third thing is the first impression as a hub of meritocracy. Again, this means that Underwood Simpson was a hub of meritocracy. Everyone was supposed to be given equal opportunity and reward, but this was the first impression, because this impression has gone away after the incident of 9/11. Just like America, it was not the true about meritocracy of Underwood Simpson. It was just apparently meritocracy, not the true symbol of prejudice and racism and imperialism, were also symbol of Underwood Simpson after 9/11. First it was the hub of meritocracy, then it was become the symbol of prejudice, racism and imperialism, because there was prejudice in Underwood Simpson, the members of Underwood Simpson, after the Chinggis has let his beard grow. Everyone become indifferent towards him. They start to suspect him. They were considering him terrorist. They were considering him facilitator. They were feeling that he has sympathy for terrorism, and because he has a beard. So it was the symbol of prejudice, racism, and imperialism too. Later on, first impression was different. Second impression was different. So moving forward, our third symbol, which is the fall of Twin Tower, or the destruction of World Trade Center. World Trade Center was consist of two towers, Twin Tower. So Twin Tower also represent the American domination, and the fall of Twin Tower ultimately will mean that the fall of American domination and dignity and power. So fall of Twin Tower can be symbolized as comeuppance for America, because according to Chinggis, it was comeuppance for America because America has bombed many other countries. So it was the outcome of America cruelty towards other countries. So it's a symbol of two things: American domination. So fall of Twin Tower means fall of American domination for Chinggis. It was a symbol of comeuppance for America due to his cruelty in other countries. So next we will move forward towards our fourth symbol, the symbol of name. The author has also used the names of characters as a symbols in this novel. Chinggis, if we remove the letter Z from the name of Chinggis, it represents change. So what type of change? This is a change from its initial position to the end position. At first, in the start of the novel, he was a different person. He was trying to be a corporate American. He was trying to be a American. He was trying to adopt the culture of America. But after the incident of 9/11, after the falling of Twin Tower, he has realized that he was alone in America. No one was accepting him due to his beard. So he started to feel reclamation, sympathy towards his culture. He was reclaiming his cultural identity, his Pakistani identity. So change means the change through which the Chinggis goes through, from the initial part of the novel towards the end part of the novel. So it is also the change of identity. At first he was American, then he reclaimed his identity as a Pakistani through self-realization. Second is Erica. Erica also symbolizes America. Same like America, she is wealthy, she is prestigious, but having all this, despite of having all this, everything, Erica cannot be protected due to his underlying malice then destroy her. So just like America, America was powerful, America was prestigious, America was well, but he cannot probably protect her from terrorism, from terrorists, and his trade center was destroyed despite having all this because of his underlying malice that destroyed her. Just like the Erica, who cannot protect her due to his underlying feelings. So the relationship of between the Erica and Genghis, this also is an allegory, and this allegory is a symbol of relationship between the Muslim world and the American U.S. United States. Just like this relation, Genghis is in passionate love with Erica, but Erica cannot love him due to his insecurities, due to his wounds. He cannot do this. And just like this, the America cannot improve his relation with Muslim world. He also, America also tried to label terrorism with entire Muslim world. So this is why the relationship between these nations, the Muslim world nations and America, so due to their this type of attitude. Just so Erica here symbolizes America, and Genghis symbolizes change, and the relation between the Genghis and Erica symbolizes the relationship between the America and the Muslim world. So moving forward towards our fifth symbol, which is the symbol of birds. Here we will read the quotation from the novel I have quoted here. I will read it. But bats have survived here. They are successful urban dwellers like you and I, swift enough to escape detection and canny enough to hunt among the crowd. So here Genghis is telling the stranger American who is sitting with him on the table of tea that is telling about the different allegory of animals, that some animals do not some animals survive and some cannot survive in a different culture. So bats are successful urban dwellers like you and I, just like you and me, because I also survive in America. I also adopt American culture. They are also sweet enough to escape detection. You also enough to escape detection, can enough to hunt among the crowd. So it here bats are symbolizing the difficulty faced by diaspora while they are adopting the foreign culture. Like Genghis was also diaspora. He was not Native American, so he has to work hard to be American, to transform himself in American. But despite of all this, at the end he find disappointment from America and left America. In literature, the symbol of bats also represents the death and rebirth. Here I have concluded that this is the death and rebirth of identity of Genghis. At first he was trying to be American, his identity was American, but after 9/11 his identity vanished and he was facing identity crisis. But after self-realization, he got his native identity, Pakistani. So his identity of so it's the death of his identity and rebirth of his real identity. So it's a symbol of death and rebirth. Moving forward, our last symbol, which is the C symbol in our presentation in this session, which is a symbol of a cup of tea. In the whole novel, the cultural exchange has been used to make trust between the people. So here is the cup of tea is symbolizing the cultural item. At first, stranger was hesitant to accept the tea cup, but Changiz exchanged their tea cup of tea and he started to drink tea. So this cultural exchange improved their trust, and this is a result of this, that after this, when waiter brings green tea, the stranger American accepted it more readily as he was not accepting before. So it's a symbol of culture exchange, property, and culture exchange is the mean of creating trust in this novel. We can also say that it's a property is a mean of trap, that he was trying to trap America by property, and he was not trying he was not trying to make trust between them. But it's it will remain undecided, as ending of the novel suggests that we can't know that trust was developed between them or not. So it can be the mean of trap, but it can also be the mean of trust, developing trust as a cultural exchange. So here we conclude our discussion. The symbol used in the novel Reluctant Fundamentalist. So from my side, it is over. Thank you very much.